Hi students, today we are going to discuss about the next topic, that is potential difference. We know that flow of charges produce current. That means when charge moves from one place to another place, current is produced. We know that the current flows through conductors. Here I have taken a conductor, a copper wire. Copper is a good conductor of electricity. For the transmission of electricity, we prefer copper. But will the current flow through the copper wire now? No. In this condition, the charges will not move. So there is a condition for the movement of charges. So what is that condition? We are going to study about that. We know that water flows from higher level to lower level. If you keep water in a horizontal pipe, the same level, water will not flow. It has a natural tendency to flow from higher level to lower level. Will it flow from lower level to higher level? Naturally, it does not happen. So, for the flow of water, there should be height difference. Then only water moves. And this movement or flow of water is called a water current. For the water current, there should be a difference in the height level. Similarly, air moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. So there should be a difference in pressure for the movement of air. And this movement of air is called a air current. So for the movement of water, there should be difference in the height. For the movement of air, there should be difference in pressure. Similarly, for the movement of charges, there should be some difference in the electric pressure. So there should be some electric pressure difference. Then only charge moves from one place to another place. And this difference in electric pressure is called a potential difference. If you create a potential difference, then only charge moves from one place to another place. And this movement of charges produces electricity. And this electricity we call it as electric current. Flow of charges is called electric current. So how to produce this potential difference? Or how to move these charges? For that, we have to connect this conductor to a battery or a cell. A battery has a positive terminal and a negative terminal. Due to this difference in this potential, electric potential, charge flows from one terminal of the conductor to the other terminal. This constitutes electric current. Consider a conductor. For example, I considered a copper wire. And to create a potential difference, we have to connect it to a battery or a cell. So by using that, by that method, one side becomes positive, other side becomes negative. So an electric pressure difference is created here. If both sides were positive, what will happen? Both sides are of same potential, charge will not flow. If both sides are negative also, due to the same potential, charge will not move. So we will make one side positive and other side negative by using a battery. So this will create an electric potential difference. And due to this, charge flows from higher potential to lower potential. But actually, the charges. And actually, electrons are moving in the circuit. Electrons are the charges moving. But conventionally, it is taken as directional current as from positive terminal to negative terminal. So when this potential difference is created, these electrons are attracted by the positive terminal. So they will move, electrons will move. And when they move through this conductor and reaches this other end, positive terminal, current is produced. The movement of charges produce current. So this is a way of making potential difference in a conductor. We have to connect it to a battery. Due to this difference in potential, charge flows, and this flow of charge is called electric current. So potential difference is created by using a battery. This potential difference is denoted by the symbol V. V is used to denote potential difference. We usually call this name as voltage, but scientifically it is named as potential difference. Symbol is V. So this battery is giving the potential difference. That means this battery is doing some work. What is the work done by the battery? Due to this battery, this charges are moving. So this battery is moving the charge from one end of the conductor to the other end. So it is doing some work. So potential difference is defined as, potential difference is defined as the work done to move unit charge, what is unit charge? What is the unit of charge? Coulomb is the unit of charge. So unit charge means 1 coulomb of charge. So potential difference is defined as the work done to move unit charge from one point to the other point. So who is doing the work here? The battery is doing the work. And the work done to move a unit charge, if 1 coulomb of charge is taken from one point to the other point, then that is called a potential difference. So mathematically, potential difference is defined as work done divided by, what's the symbol of charge? It is Q. So potential difference is equal to work done divided by charge. Now what is the SI unit of potential difference? We know that SI unit of work done is joule. Joule is the SI unit of work done. Then what is the SI unit of charge? It is coulomb. So the SI unit of potential difference is joule per coulomb. Or we will write as V joule coulomb raised to minus 1. But to honor a scientist named Alessandro Volta, the SI unit of potential difference is given as volt. So volt is the SI unit of potential difference. This volt is denoted by the letter V. So potential difference and its SI unit is having the same symbol V. So the SI unit of potential difference is volt. Potential difference is equal to work done divided by charge. SI unit of potential difference is volt. SI unit of work done is joule. Charge it is coulomb. So how will you define 1 volt? 1 volt is equal to 1 joule by 1 coulomb. That means if 1 joule of work is done, if 1 joule of work is done to move 1 coulomb of charge, 1 coulomb charge from one point to another point in a conductor, then the potential difference is 1 volt. So 1 volt is a potential difference created if 1 joule of work is done to move 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point. How will you measure potential difference in a circuit? We know that current is measured by a device called an ammeter. And this potential difference is measured by another device that is called a voltmeter. So voltmeter is used to measure potential difference. It is having both positive and negative terminals. And this voltmeter, we have to connect parallel in a circuit. Voltmeter should be connected in parallel. but ammeter should be connected in series and parallel connections. You will study later in this same chapter. Let us do one problem. The problem is, how much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across 2 points having a potential difference 12 volt? The question is, how much work is done? 2 coulomb charge is given, 12 volt is the potential difference. So write the symbols for this potential difference. What is the symbol? V. V is 12 volt. 2C means charge is given. Charge symbol is Q. Charge is 2 coulomb. We want to find out the work done. We already know the equation. Potential difference is equal to work done divided by charge. Work done is equal. Therefore, work done is equal to V into Q. What is V? 12. Q is 2. 12 into 2. It is 24. It is joule. Okay, this is the answer. The second question is, how much energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through a 6 volt battery? So charge is passing through a conductor. It is connected to a 6 volt battery. So how much energy is given to each coulomb of charge? So we can write the data given in the question. Here you can see 6 volt battery. So potential difference you can write 6 volt. Each coulomb, that means charge is 1 coulomb. What is the energy? We know that as per work energy theorem, energy is equal to work done. So that means we want to find out the work done. Use the same equation. V is equal to W by Q. Therefore, W equal to V into Q. That is 6 into 1. Answer is 6 joule. So these are direct questions. Next, we are going to study about the symbols of different electric components. We know that to draw a circuit diagram, we need to know the symbols. And you are familiar with the some symbols. You know that cell is represented by a bigger line and a smaller line. Big line shows positive terminal, smaller one shows negative terminal. So what is the symbol of battery? That is one bigger line, smaller line. That means combination of two or more cells is called a battery. So in a circuit, a key or switch is must. So key is represented by, this is key open. When the key is open, current will not flow. The circuit will be open circuit. And key closed. How you draw key closed? This is the symbol for key closed. When the key is closed, then only current flows through that. Then, next one is wire joint. If two wires are joining, that is represented by the symbol. This is one wire, then another wire is joining with this wire. This shows wire joint. Next one, wires crossing without joining. This is joining, but how to draw wires crossing without joining? This is one wire, the next wire is coming, and this shows two wires are crossing but they are not touching each other. Where this figure shows wires crossing without joining. Then you are familiar with the symbol of bulb. Bulb, this is the symbol. Then next one is a new component for you, that is a resistor. You will study about what is resistor in the next topic. A resistor is denoted by S. The next one is a variable resistor. Variable resistor is denoted by the symbol, the resistor symbol, then one arrow cross. This shows a variable resistor. Or there is one more symbol. This also shows variable resistor. Then two important components, that is ammeter and voltmeter. Ammeter and voltmeter, what is the symbol? Very simple. Ammeter A should be written in a round box. Then two terminals, one terminal is positive, other one is negative. The voltmeter also V is used, then positive terminal and negative terminal. So these are the main important components and their symbols used. Once again, cell, battery, these are familiar to you. Then key open and closed, wires joining. Then wires crossing without joining, bulb, resistor, a zigzag line, variable resistor, the resistor with an arrow, or this is a symbol, ammeter, A in a round, and a positive terminal, negative terminal should be shown, voltmeter. So these are the symbols used.